the first time I think we took part in with Spilani. And it was nice. Like, I had zero clue about robotics before. Like, I had a very, very brief understanding about robotics. But going there, they're like, oh, we're competing with engineering college kids. Nice. We're the youngest who are there. A lot of like judgments, a lot of people asking us questions. And but still, it was so much learning. It was so much fun also.
Yeah, it was a big day for me too, because I remember you guys came fourth or fifth.
Yeah.
And then you were all like at each other. Like, this did not happen, that did not happen. And I remember having a tough conversation with you guys on the way back in the bus.
Yeah.
And what began here is actually, he's being modest about it. But these two guys, right, like Murugang and Kabir, they met these engineering folks. And Kabir already knew one guy, Devansh, I guess. And they joined a robotics club of a college, like all Goan college students. These guys joined that club. And they actually went to IIT Madras, right? Later. You went to IIT Madras for
comedy. No, I didn't go. Murugang went.
Ah, so one of you went.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the whole reason for bringing this up is he was proactive right from, like, you know, when he was 10, 12 years old. It's not that it just happened in a day, right? He'll be telling us more about his journey, because 5 years back he was your age, right? So in another 5 years, you will be his age. Yeah. Just one second. That was my dad's phone. Yeah. We'll start, I guess. I think we have enough participants. How many are there? Can you tell me the count? I can't see.
It's 15.
This is good enough.
15.
To start.
Sir, I joined now.
Huh, so we'll start now. So Kabir, you want me to present what stuff? The Canva thing?
Yeah, you can present that first. Okay. That would be good.
Papa. Wait,
yes. Guys, hi, I'm Kabir. Before we start the presentation, I'll just
can you see the presentation?
Yeah, I can see your screen.
Yes. So it's loading, I guess.
Yeah, it's loading.
Is it public, Baba?
Yeah, it's public. Your net is slow.
Okay. So do I?
There's a button called present. See there.
Yeah, wait. I can't see things. My net is giving me issues. Usually it doesn't. Where's the present button? I never presented on Canva before.
Oh, it's on the, it should be keynote share, next to share.
It's loading. On the top. I can also see it.
I couldn't see it. I don't know why. Like, it was not loading or something. I don't know.
Yeah, standard.
Present?
Yes.
So these people also use Canva. So guys, you know that you can make presentations on Canva now.
It's the best to make presentations. Like, my graphic designer, it's good because a lot of people can collaborate on one project, and it's free also. So you just tell people what changes you need and stuff. And
they have a pro version. I've given them a pro version, which my friend has.
Oh, that's really good.
I'll share the details with you also if you need.
Yeah. I think I use the GitHub Wala Pro thing, GitHub developer package.
Okay.
Like it, something. So yeah.
Anyways, yeah, GitHub student package. It's called like that.
Guys, show your faces now, Baba. it's nice to see people and not. Kabir was like online, though I'm not coming. Okay. So I said I'll make sure they show their faces to you. Please do that. Thank you.
Yes. Go ahead. Hello. Welcome to the presentation. Let's do this as a very, not a presentation, which I'm used to, but a very informal chat with you and me. It's going to be a very open-ended thing. You can ask me, you can interrupt me anytime. You can just unmute and ask me whatever you feel like. And it's going to be fun. It's going to be a nice journey. So without, like, before, just to get things clear, all of you guys use social media, all of you guys use YouTube. Like, have you all been surfing through YouTube and stuff? If you could unmute and tell me.
So yes. All of you use. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Not much. Aray,
not much. Not much.
Not much.
Okay. Nice. Okay. What channels do you all watch on YouTube?
I don't watch tech channels.
Maths and science. Even me. Maths, science, and coding channels.
I watch YouTube. And maths channels also. Minecraft, course. Coding sometimes and things like that. And also math.
That's a lot of diversity. That's nice. Any YouTubers that you guys really like? Anyone you follow often? You subscribe to?
Yeah, I have lots. I have about 100.
That's crazy. That's really good. So yeah, I'm Kabir Naik. You can go to the next slide. I'm currently a documentary filmmaker. I've been making films for the past 6 years now. I specialize, like I started as a YouTube content creator around 4 years back. But now I have my own production company. It's called Kazula Productions. We specialize in documentaries. We make films about cultural communication, rural issues, and agrarian distress, environmental degradation, and culture, and all these kind of things. So now though we are a full-time production company. We have editors, we have drone pilots, it's a big deal over here in Goa, if you'll have watched any of the documentaries that we've made. But I started out as a content creator itself on YouTube. And it's been a crazy journey from just recording a video literally on my phone. Like I didn't have anything else. I just have a phone. I had a phone to edit, to shoot everything. And it was a terrible phone, absolutely terrible. But for 1.5 years, I made videos every single day. Like every day vlogs I used to put up and every day edits, every day like videos. And I think that taught me so much. Like no one used to watch them. It used to get 2 views, 5 views. I myself have never watched, don't want to go back and watch those videos, but it taught me so much about editing, about cinematography, about everything that I like know till now. And now we are entering this festivals and like a film called Pressure. It was just a few days back screened at Slovenia. At Luxor's Film Festival. It's India's only documentary to ever be screened at this prestigious film festival. And it really feels nice that this is happening. And it's a beautiful documentary. You guys, I can share the link with you guys if you want to watch it. Also, a film called Bhuiput. It was about agrarian crisis. And it got the Silver Gaja at Kid Cinema International Film Festival. So a lot of awards in the traditional media space also. So yeah, that's what I do. That's what I love doing. Right now I'm studying at Delhi University. So it's not that I'm only making films. I also got into a pretty good college, the top in my domain in what I'm doing, political science in the country. So yeah, that balance also I try to maintain. And I'm just so happy that I got into college because of my filmmaking, because of what I did and through all the like effort that we put into this film. I think Dhruv has a question. Is that a hand raise? I don't know how this thing works.
Yes. Why did you want to become a filmmaker first of all? I think there are many other exciting professions which you can choose.
Yeah. I wanted to become a filmmaker because that's all I've done. That's all literally I've dreamt of. That's all I've wanted to do. That's all I've just like done for the last 5 years. And once you're so obsessed with something, you won't even like budge and do something else. Like just that innate feeling, which I feel really happy when I film, when I, even till now, you know, even when you're doing commercial work, even when you're doing these projects, they are very hectic, but there's this sense of satisfaction, which I've never ever got through anything else. And I've tried so many things before, as I said, like robotics and all these kind of things, but I honestly was never really content and I was never happy as such doing it from within. But it was a very nice time of my life. But I think filmmaking changed everything for me. And it's given me a voice that nothing has given me ever. And I think that's why I want to become a filmmaker. I want to tell stories. That's my motto. I tell stories. And I want to tell stories about this country to the world. One day maybe get an Oscar in documentary filmmaking. Never know. That's the goal. That's the vision that we are working on. So yeah. That's about me. I guess that's all. I mean, if you all want to ask me anything about myself, you can ask me now. We can move on. I studied in Sharda Mandir. It's a very, I don't know how many of you guys are from Sharda Mandir. It's a nice school. I won't say anything bad about it. But yeah, whoever is going there, guys, enjoy. It's pretty good. Otherwise, though, I was always a part of it. Like, I was a part of Vidyavriksh since a long time, and you know, Vidyavriksh has also shaped a lot of how I interact with people, how I communicate, how I talk to people and all that. So yeah, let's go next and let's just get into some YouTube thing. You came back, I think. So this is my YouTube channel. I have around 3,200 subscribers on YouTube. I was very inconsistent this year. If you see the videos, it's like 4 months back, 3 months back, 2 months back. I was very, very inconsistent this year because I was more focusing on professional documentary stuff and couldn't give enough time to YouTube. But I can proudly say this is one of the biggest channels of Goa, which has a good amount of viewer retention and stuff. So if you guys ever want to check out my stuff, if I ever put stuff on YouTube, which I will, I'm going to continue posting stuff very soon in Jan. A lot of videos are planned out. So you guys could check my YouTube channel out. I've been running the channel for the last 1.5 years. Before this, I had several more channels. Very weird. Like if you'll see them, you'll be like, what is this? This is totally different from what he's doing now. Yes, someone has a question, I think.
So what are these videos about?
Okay, so most of these videos are about the culture, about heritage, about documentaries about Goa. And it's something that I do. It's about telling stories. Like if you see People for Animals is about the first video over here. It's about this organization who is doing veterinary care for street animals. Then there's an ad film which we made, and there's Beyond Sight, which is about a blind person from the most rural village of Goa, and how he lives his day, how he writes poems and all that. And then there is Bhuipu, then there is some other videos which we make. So there are a lot of bunch of videos, but the central themes are documentaries, that the central themes are about Goa culture and all these kind of things. So yeah, that's about my channel. I also have a very active Instagram, and I post a lot over there too. Yes, you can ask me whatever you want. Viraj.
So, did you start your YouTube channel? Did you get support from anyone, or you were like, just let's start this YouTube channel?
I mean, I didn't tell my parents until like I had made like 20 videos. Like I didn't want to tell them because they were very supportive of everything that I've done. But I myself thought that it wasn't really worth telling anyone because they were like really bad. Like I remember my friend had sent him the video. He's like, this is terrible. Like, just stop doing it. But, you know, just continuing through all this, I don't know why. Now, if you ask me this question, I'm just wondering, why did I not stop? But I just continued. It felt nice. It felt that it was giving me satisfaction. And I kept doing it. I didn't study at all. Like I studied very, very less, the minimal amount of study that is required for a human being to like just pass. That's what I have done throughout. And that was how this channel started. Just I was going on a Europe trip And I said, let's take a camera, let's take my phone and just record everything. So I just started that way. It went on really well. It made me really like this medium. I love talking. If you've not realized it till now, I just like love yapping and talking about a lot of things. So that's how it came about. And then cinematography, and then visual storytelling, and then storytelling in general, all these concepts developed on each other. And this channel was born. That's the story of this channel. So that we had very different channels before this. I had a channel with my friends, which is not deleted. I had my own separate channel before this, but this is a totally rebranded version of my YouTube journey. This is not my entire YouTube journey. I have a lot of other channels also before, but it was mainly a learning experience for me. I told you guys, like, I made a video every single day for 1.5 years. Like, if you just think about it, it's crazy. It sounds very stupid. Like, it's very unhealthy. I'm not even joking. It was very, very unhealthy for mental health, for your own physical health. You're literally recording, shooting, thinking of what to say all the time. You have nothing else in your mind. But that trains you to be impromptu. That trains you to be like whatever you can say without being really prepared, or you don't, anyone has to not give you a script. And that's the most beautiful thing I feel about just learning to talk very well. So that's how the channel started. And that's been the journey. Yeah, if anyone has anything to ask me about it, okay, you can go ahead. Yeah.
How did you start your channel? Like, did someone start it for you or started it on your own?
On my own, like everything I did, like I literally Googled how to start a YouTube channel and just started a YouTube channel. It was the most mundane thing that I did. It was just like, I'm just doing this for the sake of it. Let's see where it takes me. It was just like starting an Instagram account or a Facebook account, not knowing what you're going to do on it, but just doing it because you just wanted to see how it works. Very, very basic. I had no plans of becoming YouTuber. I didn't want to become a filmmaker. I wanted to become an astrophysicist, if so remembers. I wanted to do astronomy, and I wanted to do very hardcore science and all these things. I was a lot into astronomy also that time, but yeah, see, paths changed. I decided to do something totally different. Yes, Aviraj, I think, has a question. No, is his hand raised? I don't know.
Viraj, could you unmute yourself?
That's all right. It's fine. Yeah. So anyways, let's get to the fundamentals of, you know, it's a very interesting concept. This is storytelling at the most pure form. So when you see this picture, what do you think of? What's the first thing that comes to your mind?
I think it is an ancient painting which is based on animals.
Like a village or a kingdom.
Super old cave painting.
Anything else? Anyone want to say anything?
World's oldest cave painting.
Okay.
Cave painting of animals.
All of you.
Painting of animals. Ancient paintings on rocks.
Absolutely. All are right. All answers are right. Everything is right. But, you know, at the... Yes? Oh, it's cave painting itself, right? Yeah, all of you guys are absolutely right. But you know, at the base of it, at the core of whatever you all have said, this is storytelling. Humans, even before having a language, this was before language as a concept was formed. Humans were doing this. Humans were painting out stories on walls. Like, they had to survive. Why would they tell stories? Like, they would be eaten by some animal. They had no security of if they're going to live or not, but they painted. They literally told stories, and that's how important storytelling is to human life. there are so many stories going on in this. You can make an entire short film. You can make an entire web series on all the things that are going on in this painting. And just thinking about how complex and how many things they've drawn over here. They've expressed so much. Like, if we didn't have this painting, we wouldn't know the stories of that time. Can you all think about that? How crazy it would have been. Just how impossible it had been for us to understand what was happening back then. They have literally stored this memory for eternity, or until this cave painting lasts. And that's what art is. That's what storytelling is. It's preserving and protecting ideas and memories for eternity. And that's why I feel storytelling is the most fundamental thing. We say that humans went and hunted first, had food first, all these things humans did, absolutely. But what humans also did at the start of human civilization is storytelling. Storytelling has always, always, always been a very crucial part of human existence, of a fulfilled human existence in general. You can go next. So I feel human telling stories makes us human, and all of us, right? All of us tell stories in different mediums. Who all sing over here? Is there anyone who sings? Siddharth sings. Oh, you also sing. That's so nice. So everyone who sings is also telling a story. Is telling a story through changes in music formats, or through changes in through words. All these are just stories at the base of it. If anyone writes, does anyone like writing? Does anyone do creative writing?
Yes, I do.
Yeah, exactly. You're also telling a story. You're telling a story through the most fundamentals of storytelling, which is writing and saving and putting your ideas on paper. Anyone who does dance, does anyone dance? Does anyone like to dance? Amazing. That also is storytelling. Everything that humans do, filmmaking, you know, photography, every single thing is storytelling. Like, dance is also storytelling. You're expressing your emotions through your face, expressing how your movements are, what you're feeling at that point. And that's such a beautiful thing to do. So everything is storytelling, and humans are so surrounded by now, right now also, before joining this meet, you must have told your friends, hey, I have this meet, I don't know, like, today also one day, so I didn't give us holiday, so boring, come on, like, why did you do this, we have to attend today also, it's literally new year, like, sir couldn't even leave us for one day. And this is also a story, right? You all are telling your friends, this is happening, that is happening, in a very engaging manner. Yes. You're adding some conflict to it, saying that, why is sir doing this to us? You know, you're adding so many elements of storytelling to it. And that is storytelling. Everyone, every human being does storytelling every single day. And what we as content creators do is just put out these stories for a wider audience. That's the base of content creation. Whatever your medium may be, we just tell stories to a lot of people. You tell stories to your friend. We tell stories to a lot of people. That's it. That's all the difference that is. And if you know to talk to one person, you can talk to 1,000 people, to 10,000 people, to 1,00,000 people, to 10,00,000 people. Always remember that. And never feel, this is just telling you all this very randomly, but never feel that you all are inferior or you all are less as compared to anyone or someone who's elder than you. Never feel that. If you like to do something, leave everyone else, leave whatever everyone else is telling you all, and just do it. Don't think about it like 500 times, or just don't keep thinking about it. Just do it. You'll actually be very, very happy when it actually works out for you. And that time, other people's opinions won't really matter. It won't. You will be happy. So just putting it out there. Okay, it makes me feel like I'm old now. Okay, next.
So
you are.
Yes. Yes.
Won't listening to others' advices just help you improve? Like, by using others' advices, you can make some small changes in your videos or something.
Absolutely, dude. Like, see, everyone's advice 100% helps you. But remember one thing, like never let it affect your style. Because if you keep listening to everyone's advice, you'll form this in creative fields, especially. I don't know how it works for science fields, but at least in creative fields, the less you listen to other people, the more unique and more adapted your own style will become. Like you as a storyteller will develop more. Because other people have a preconceived idea, like this is what, how it's to be done. This is how it's to be done. This is how a video is to be made. This is how a film is to be made. This is how a story is to be told. You don't have to do that. That's the beauty of storytelling. You don't have to listen to anyone. You can do it from within.
Kabir, let me just interrupt here a bit.
Yeah.
Okay, when Kabir says don't listen to anyone, it doesn't mean that he has not taken advice from people. So advice always gives you a different perspective. It is up to you whether you listen to it or not, right? So you have to listen to it you have to have a sort of understanding of who you are and what that other person is saying. And if it makes sense, then you make changes. If it doesn't make sense, then you don't do it. So when Kabir says don't listen to anyone, he doesn't mean like, you know, be arrogant about it.
Yeah.
Kabir is one person I know has collaborated a lot with other people. He asks for feedback. So Kabir, it's coming out wrong. That's why I'm
No, I'm not saying that ignore everyone else's opinions and all. I'm saying that have your own voice. Whatever you do, listen to other people. That's the beauty of creative fields also. Like what I can do, someone else can't do. And what someone else can do, suppose someone is a better storyteller or better story writer, is a writer, I should collaborate with them. I should listen to them in that particular field. But don't let that affect you. Don't let that say that if someone tells you that this is bad, you should stop doing it. Don't let that affect you. That should never be something that you should do. You should always move forward, take criticism, work on it. Never just like take criticism for the sake of it, but work on that criticism. And then you'll be able to like find this own voice of yours, which will be what defines you, which will be what is what you are on this world. And that when you find that, right, that's true nirvana, that's true bliss. Even I haven't found it, honestly. I have a long way to go, but I'm just telling you, I feel I'm on a good track right now. And yeah, it's also nice to be on the right path here and there. So yeah, they don't like ignore what people say, but take people's opinions, understand it, filter it out, what is important, what is not, and then take a rational decision. You all are capable enough to take rational decisions, and do take them sometimes, at least here and there. So yes, you can go next. Social media, it's a very, very wide concept. You know, there are so many forms of social media out there today. There's YouTube, Instagram, WhatsApp, TikTok, Facebook, LinkedIn, every single platform. And every single platform has such, you know, every single platform has its own unique characteristics. Who of you all, any of you guys use Twitch maybe? Anyone's on Twitch? I don't think so. Okay.
So I'm there.
Oh, that's really nice.
Twitch is a streaming platform, right?
Yes, I'm there.
Oh, that's really cool. Yeah, a lot of people use Twitch for streaming.
Yeah.
So it's a nice place to be on. There are a lot of focus groups. You have nice discussions and stuff. YouTube, though, I think a lot of you already told me you use Instagram. Are you all on Instagram? Are you all not?
Yes, sir.
No, okay. Sir.
Nice. Are you guys, you don't need to call me so very weird. It feels. Yeah. You can call me.
I'm on Instagram.
Okay, that's nice. Anyone else is like, are y'all not on Instagram? Anything like that?
I'm on Instagram.
No, I'm not on Instagram.
Not on Instagram.
Not on Instagram. Not on Instagram.
Okay, nice.
It's too early for all of them, I guess. Isn't for some who are doing stuff, yes, great. For content consumers, it's too early, and I think parents are not really.
Yeah. It's good also. Instagram is a very stupid. It makes you dumb, like honestly telling you this.
The only reason I joined Instagram is for the artist group that we made a few months ago.
I joined Insta just because of my business.
Yeah, I mean, Instagram is a very convoluted platform, but I feel if you use it properly, you can like it like any other platform, but it's not a very necessary platform to be. I feel YouTube has this power which no other platform has, and it's such a nice platform. You can learn, see, whatever I know till now about filmmaking, about content creation, I know through YouTube itself. I've not done any course, I've not done any kind of, I've not paid even 1 rupee to anyone to learn filmmaking at all. I've learned every single thing through YouTube, and there is so much material out there. I can send you a few links if you all are interested on how and where to learn all these kind of things. There's this channel called as Colin and Samir, Colin and Samir, Colin and Samir. They break down YouTube videos and understand the algorithm. So that's a very beautiful channel to watch. So there are so many of these kind of content creators. I'll tell Sir to send you guys, I'll make a list and send you guys a few, so you'll also are aware of what's happening in the space. It's a very, very nice thing to do, and just to understand how these platforms work. So basically, this is this new age medium or social media that we all are familiar with, that we all have heard at least once or twice. Yep, you can go next. So what are all the type of content? Like, do you guys know what all types of content exist in this in the world? Like, what is the different types of content that's out there?
Vlogging.
Okay.
Blogging.
Gaming.
Mm-hmm. Or coding tutorials.
Programming.
All different kinds of tutorials.
Technology, science.
Mm-hmm.
Comedy.
Sir, you go listing them, everything is a content.
Yeah, that's what the last person said is absolutely true. Everything is content. There's content for everyone. There's content for everyone to consume, everyone to make. Whatever you like to make, you can make it on YouTube. Whatever you like to consume, you can consume that on YouTube. And that's the beauty of YouTube. There's everything available for everyone. That is also now short form content, these 15 second reel videos and all. I must have seen a few of those, like those videos, yes, that get shared a lot and stuff. So that's also getting a lot of traction. And if you all want to do your YouTube career, or you may just like make some money through YouTube and stuff, reels is a very, very good medium to get into. Whatever people have said about TikTok, like if you all know that there was a lot of hate that was going on around TikTok, but it literally changed the platform. It changed how we consume content. You know, during the lockdown, people are just like scrolling through their phones and just seeing reels of people dancing, people cooking, people swimming, people like doing every sort of thing to random music and all that. So there's a lot of content out there that you can explore and do. Yes, you can go next. So we will be talking about YouTube. We could go next. YouTube is my favorite platform. It's what I started out with. It's what I love the most as compared to any other platform. It's the hardest to grow compared to Instagram, compared to any other platform, to Twitter, compared to any other social media site. YouTube is the hardest to grow and hardest to crack. So, but if you understand YouTube, right, you can understand any other algorithm. That's why any other platform, any other content. So that's why we are talking about YouTube. Okay. Yes, next. So what are the types of YouTube videos? You're already told me a bunch of names, right? A bunch of things, commentary videos, review videos. Does anyone make YouTube videos in the class?
So I make.
Okay. What do you
make?
Yes, sir, I make.
Could you all tell me about your channels?
So I have a kind of a gaming channel. I sometimes post coding tutorials. It's commentary plus gaming and educational.
Okay.
I have a channel where I do coding. I do reviews. I'm also doing challenges sometimes. And sometimes, yep. Yeah.
I had a coding and gaming channel, but it got deleted.
How it got deleted?
I messed with the age in my Gmail and it getting deleted.
Oh, that's sad. May make a channel again. Anyone else who has a channel?
Kabir, hi, this is Pratik here. So yeah, I make videos. I always comment on your big fan of your work, by the way. I'm not a student. I'm a Siddharaj's friend, so I just attended this because he told me you'll be there.
Oh, thank you so much. That means a lot. That means so much. Like, I'm so happy now. But yeah, so
whoever... By the way, Kabir, this Pratik has done his engineering 2 years back and he's following Kabir's work. So what I'm trying to say is age is not a bar, right? So, you know, tomorrow you guys can, you know, help me build my content. If you, obviously Kabir is helping me already, but you guys can also get on the
bandwagon. Absolutely. That'll be amazing. You guys should make content. Like I'm so, like, so happy that you're all making content. I think during my, like, our time in the batch, Sridhar used to make videos before me. We are still in touch and stuff, but he's doing a lot of crazy stuff. He's doing a lot of amazing stuff. And you know, when one person makes it in the class, everyone else is like, okay, if he can do it or she can do it, why can't I? That's the beauty of, I think, just peer groups and having this community, like people who are supporting you. So guys, collaborate, like whatever channels you'll have a lot of things in common. So collaborate with each other, make some stuff, do some crazy, crazy, crazy stuff. So now, see, now these are the types of YouTube videos in general. The ones I've marked in red are the ones which are the most popular, like tutorials, comedy, narratives, educational. These are the ones that algorithm promotes a lot, that YouTube promotes a lot, and people love to watch. Like, see, comedy is evergreen. Remember one thing, people will literally watch comedy anytime. And it has always a market. Educational also has a lot of market because people want to know how to do stuff, how to do this, how to do that. Tutorials come into the same bracket as such. And narratives, people always are drawn to storytelling, right? And that's why narratives are a concept that exists and people love to watch them. But there are so many other. Gaming is a big thing. There's a lot of money in gaming. Like, a lot of big companies are investing a lot of money and resources to start their own gaming channels and gaming teams. So if you all into gaming, continue doing it. Don't put a lot of time into it, like, balance it out. But if you are doing it, it's an amazing place to be in. A lot of people are doing it around the world, but you can stand out. You can have your own voice in this entire mess, and you can do something which is not done. Then also Q&A, commentary videos, interviews, docu-series. This is what I do. Docu-series, documentaries is the kind of content that I personally make. And these are the basic types of videos. So what I realized when I asked you all about your channels is that you are doing a bunch of these, right? In one kind of category, in one kind of idea, or in one kind of genre. But what I would want to say is stick to one. Don't overdo with all these stuff. Like, someone's doing comedy, someone's doing tutorials and educational. That's very hard for you to grow. Because even any human being, right? If one person tells you a lot of different things about themselves, it will be hard for you to connect with that person. But if that person tells you only one amazing thing about them, that will have more of an impact on you. So how we humans are designed is to associate one person with one particular kind of expertise. So I also was making this mistake. This is a big mistake a lot of people make. But try to focus and try to find your niche. When you find your niche is when you start growing. Like, y'all must be thinking, why am I not growing? Why is the channel just like not growing at all? It's because y'all are making amazing content. Amazing, like absolutely hands down crazy content, but it's very diverse. So the people who are going to come there are also going to be diverse. They're like, what am I here for? Am I here for the comedy? Am I here for the education? Am I here for the tutorial? I'm confused. I don't know what I'm doing here. But if you're like, this channel is about documentaries, the people who will come there know that whatever they're going to get documentaries once or twice in a year, here and there, to break this flow, you can upload something else because it maybe get too monotonous. So you can upload something real different. Like, what we do is we make music videos. we do a lot of protest rap in Konkani. So that's to break the monotony of documentaries. But stick to one goal, stick to one niche and grow on that niche. That is when you will actually see some amount of growth happening on your channel. Because I was like y'all itself. I didn't know what was happening wrong. What was I doing wrong? Because I was putting my leg in too many arenas. That's I think what we shouldn't do. And just focus on one thing. Yeah, you had a question, right?
So sometimes I feel like I also want to make a YouTube channel, but then I just get an idea for one video. And then after making that video, I just can't think of anything. So anything about that?
That's a really nice question. It's just that consistency is very important. Like if you start making a video and you don't upload next, it's going to die down. So how do you think of ideas? Like how do you get ideas to make videos? So what kind of videos, what was the like concept that you were wanting to make videos about? What was the idea about?
I was trying clay stop motion.
Okay, that's beautiful. I started filmmaking through clay stop motion. That was the first video I've ever made in my life. It's an amazing concept to work on. See, now clay stop motion. When you tell me this first thing, you've not told me anything else. You just told me clay stop motion. Now from this, I can derive so many things. Okay, one, you base your entire channel on clay stop motion. You brand it as India's top clay stop motion channel. Okay, you just start there. Every week you put one narrative. Whatever's going on in and around you, suppose Corona is going on. You make a clear animation about Corona. That will get shares. It will get you views. That's one thing you can do. You can make tutorials about how you made that video. Then you're looping it. The person who's interested in clear animation, he sees the video first and then he's like, huh, this is how we made it. That's amazing. And every week you'll get ideas, whatever is happening around you, metamorph it, use it in a funny way, in a nice way, give all these clay characters a voice and just tell a story through that. And every week you'll have so much, just like go on the news or go on the internet and see what's trending and just make a video about that. You don't necessarily have to do something that's trending. You can do something that you really like and just like continue. I'm saying why it's trending, because then that gives you traction. That gives you a lot of views and all that kind of stuff. If suppose a web series is trending, you can make a video about that. If something about nature is trending, make a video about clay animation about that. And like with this small bracket, you can grow so much. Maybe now you start making videos, but in the future, you may have your own clay brand. Again, you can become a big clay empire where people will actually come to you and buy your clay. Never know what can happen. You can have your own course about, monetized course about clay animation. The scope is endless. The scope which you can do, people have started business empires just by taking on small idea and making a YouTube channel about it, having a small but close-knit community, and then making this amazing, amazing like channel and business out of it. So this small idea also of clay animation, I told you, like you can make so many kind of videos. You don't have to upload weekly. You can upload once a month also. You can upload one video or story video of clay animation a month, one breakdown of the clay animation a month. That's it. People will come to you. People will wait for that story. And that will build your brand. You make everything around you centric to that. You can make, as I told you, you can make clay, you can make merchandise of this and just make it big. Never think that you have to, clay animation is a very small bracket. Everything has a huge potential. Remember that and just like keep doing and working towards it. It will be amazing. Like,
Kabir, Roma actually started a business in the lockdown.
Okay.
She does hand-painted masks. So she's pretty entrepreneurial in that sense.
That's amazing.
And she is Rujula's sister, but
oh, that's good. Rujula was my batchmate. Just say hi. I said hi to her. So yeah, that's amazing, right? See, if you have that entrepreneurial blood in you, you can use it and do amazing stuff on YouTube, especially. Like it's just a platform for you to launch and then you can reach wherever you want. That's the beauty of it. Like There's no limit to it. That's the most amazing
thing. And guys, remember that when Kabir started, he was like 8th standard or so.
Yeah.
8th standard, 9th standard. And you guys are still in 6th. If you, and he made a lot of mistakes along those 2 years, right? You also need to make those mistakes, right? It won't be like whatever Kabir has said is just a better starting point for you. You will make some different mistakes, but you will only make mistakes if you start putting content. If you don't put content, if you don't start something, then there is, then you will, you are always on the losing side because you're not doing anything. Right. So,
excuse me, Kabir, sir. I wanted to like start a YouTube channel, but like when I tried to start it, the thing I was going to start was like at I wanted to start it at like when I was in second or third grade, I think. So at that time I could not do anything because this the thing I wanted to do was like very small at the time.
What did you want to do?
A lot of videos about Rubik's cubes, like how to solve it and new things.
Rubik's cube is like if you start right now, there's so much potential. I know a friend who is doing this as a job now, as a full-time career. He has a YouTube, I don't really know, I can find out though. He has a channel which is solely dedicated to Rubik's cubes. He is making amazing, he's hosting his own competitions which people pay to take part in. He uploads weekly videos, he has interviews with other Rubik's cube solvers, he has a podcast which he's doing, and everything started just because he started posting videos about Rubik's cubes. He can now in the future maybe start his own Rubik's cube brand, or can start that Rubik's cube mat thing. He was telling me all these concepts that he had. So he started as a Rubik's cube, and you can do so much with it. You can do challenges, you can go on the street, talk to people, give people the cube and be like, how much time can you solve this in? You can do storytelling through Rubik's cube, like every color you associate with some story. There's endless potential again, and even in Rubik's cube, that this thing would seem so mundane, but a lot of potential. Remember that you can do a lot of stuff through it. I think one more question is there. Someone has raised the hand. I think. I can.
Venkatesh.
Yes, sir. Sir, when you had started your channel that time, did you pay attention at your views and your audience retention and that stuff?
No, I didn't really care. I didn't care at all. I just kept uploading. It's like, I didn't have to think about all this. I didn't have to think about, you know, if I'm making sense. It was just like this inner feeling. It's like, I'm liking to do this. I'm going to do this. That's it. Like, I don't care about anything else. I'm just like, views. I used to get 2 to 5 max views. I think that was me myself watching it over and over again. But doing this for 1.5 years, if y'all think about it, it sounds very ridiculous. Very ridiculous. Like it sounds scarily ridiculous, but it was very, very helpful. It's trained me to be who I am right now. So whoever wants to do it, try doing it. Try at least uploading frequent videos. It will really change your life. So I didn't pay attention at all to anything. Just started because I love doing it and will continue doing it, I feel. Yes.
No.
I was saying that for YouTube and things, I was starting a coding channel in which like there are coding tutorials and stuff in which HTML and things are there, and I had named it CodeBuddy, but I'm not getting any time to proceed in it.
Okay. I mean, time-wise though, see, you'll have to wake up early either, or you sleep late. Okay. You'll have to find time throughout the day. There is a lot of time we like tend to waste. Just try to utilize it in a different in a manner that you it's going through your channel. So time wise though, I feel we all have enough time. It's not that we are very, 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 very busy. We can cut out on some fun parts of life, maybe not going down to play, or maybe just like not going to party once, or just going for just like staying home and doing something, or sleeping a little later, waking up a little early, all these things. Like when I used to start, when I used to do this everyday video, see, I had school, I had tuitions, I had my robotics things going on. There's a lot of things. I used to sleep like 5 hours, and other time I was like, I'm editing this. I can't, I need to post tomorrow. And if sometimes I should not sleep itself, but just getting that thing done, right? That satisfaction when you like push that upload button, that is unmatchable. It like overrides everything. So when you have that passion coming from within you, I feel only then you should do it. You should not force yourself into everyone. Doesn't necessarily have to become a content creator. It's just that if it's pushing you from within, right? If this is telling you do it, it will automatically happen. You will find time somehow or the other. Somehow or the other, you will find time and just do it. So try to schedule a day, plan your day out, and maybe that may help.
It's like tasting a chocolate. You know, like right now, today I've brought Kabir as a guy who says I've tasted chocolate and it tastes nice. Now, the idea of this session is for you to start tasting that chocolate. Now, if you like chocolate, you will keep eating it. Right? Even if your mother says don't eat it, you will try to eat it somehow. Right?
Yes, sir.
But if you don't like it, then you may not eat it. It's up to you. Right? So not everybody has to become a YouTuber or whatever.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Even tasting chocolate is such a nice channel to start. Like, you know, just tasting chocolate, trying out different chocolates around the world, you know, going to villages and trying chocolates there, and going to the most fanciest of restaurants and trying chocolates over there. Like traveling, you never know, you may get to travel the world to literally eat chocolate. And then you can start your own chocolate brand. You can start your own chocolate factory and like have such amazing things. You can do our own series about eating chocolate and traveling the world. Crazy potential. Everything's possible through YouTube. Literally, this small idea can be a big business and a big content generation platform for all of you.
And you'll get free chocolates after a point.
Exactly.
Brands would be chocolate. Like, just eat these chocolates.
But that is actually very true, because there are shows on History TV which shows a man going everywhere eating different types of things.
Yes, food vloggers.
Yeah, food vloggers.
Getting free chocolate is the dream.
Exactly. Y'all can make it a reality, guys. Start a channel. Put yourselves out there. I'm telling you, people will come out. People
start literally with the simplest of things, you know, like just keep a camera in front of you and start recording you eating a small Alpenlibe or exactly. A small Rola Cola, whatever. Like, just choose different thing and talk about it. Okay, I like this and this is bad. Just spit it out sometimes. You know, show
make it engaging. People. Make it fun. Make
show
it
people that, you know, I don't like this. Then yeah. You'll get some comments also saying, how can you not like this chocolate? This is the best chocolate.
Absolutely. So you can start a channel on anything. That's the beauty of it, right? Like chocolates, food, everything.
Yeah, like Roma and Saria, you guys can, even Roma, for example, you have that mask making thing, right? So you can just talk about how many, like, you've got an order, now I'm doing this. You know, it's such a task, you know, whatever. Yeah. This is easy. This is not easy. Just how you make your stuff.
Absolutely. Like Roma, I feel I'll tell you this story about Casey Neistat. He was an American content creator. He's like one of the biggest YouTubers, the big, you know, the best of the lot. Okay. What he did was why he started his channel was to document this new company he was starting. It was called Beam. And he was just vlogging, daily vlogging his growth in his company, how his life was. What is it? See, you have such a nice story. A young sixth standard girl starting her own business, trying to push out masks to the world, right? This is your story. This is what will capture the world's attention to you. Now use this story, exploit this story in different ways and get to people. And when people will come to know this story, they'll be like, okay, what does she do though? Oh, what type of mask does she make? Oh, what is the kind of content she likes to watch? So you will build this personal brand around yourself. And then you can just grow. You can grow on your personal brand. Keep making content as you
also
grow.
Also, Roma, there is this other thing, you know, like there are two things that this will do. One is you making those masks for other people. And also you will start making masks just because you have to upload it on YouTube. So what will happen is it will give you more practice into your own art as well. Absolutely. And you will become better at it. It's not that Kabir was the same kind of filmmaker 5 years, 3 years back or 2 years back or even yesterday.
Absolutely.
Okay. Absolutely. So with every try, you will improve. Like some of you who are good at math can start talking about math and do it. Like, you know, like
guys, if you are good at math and if you all were in my age, like if you could simplify math and make it fun, I would literally subscribe to you, because there will be so many kids who would be like me, who I'm telling you this frankly, judge me if you want to, I hated maths, like hated maths a lot. Okay, I couldn't understand what was happening. And if you can make maths fun, you have won it. So try to make maths fun, or try to make maths, like give stories to these numbers or these concepts and grow your following there. Like whatever you love doing, you can tell a story through it. And then maybe you can start your own like coaching classes. You can monetize it anytime, but just starting it and pushing content and telling stories through what you love doing. That's I'm telling you, that's the best part. And whatever you do, right, have your own voice in it. Never try to emulate people, try to copy other people's way of doing it, but have your own method of doing it. That will set you up. That will separate you from everyone else, is what I think.
Can we move on?
Yes, yes.
And this, so you, this was, is, you spoke just now about
that. Yeah. This is the basics of starting a YouTube channel. Basically, you find your niche first, then you post consistently. You need to post, otherwise people won't take you seriously. If you don't, like I've experienced it this year, I uploaded like 7 videos. That's terrible. In my last year, I uploaded like 40-50 videos. I used to upload every week. I've seen the numbers decline, because when you upload very, very less, people don't take you really seriously. People are like, why are we coming here? He's not putting enough work into the channel. So upload consistently, post whatever you love, whatever videos you make, as frequently as possible. And then lastly, promote it. Don't be ashamed of sharing it on groups and telling your contacts and telling your family people, just putting on those family groups which are there on, and be like, this is my channel. They'll make fun of you or whatever, but you will get your voice heard. They will also come to know that you're doing this and they will support you. Not today, then maybe 10 days or 10 months or a year down the line. So this is the basic concept. Find a niche you love, post consistently, and promote your channel. Nothing else you need to do. Absolutely nothing else. Leave all the sajam, like out, like leave it outside. Don't think about anything, overcomplicate anything. Just do these 3 things. Find a niche that you love doing, and then post consistently, and lastly promote. Now we'll do a little bit of understanding this YouTube as a concept. Okay, it's very interesting. You guys like coding, you guys love numbers, right? So we can understand YouTube as an algorithm, not as, you know, a very creative, though it's obviously there. But if you want to grow on YouTube, you need to understand the algorithm side of YouTube. So yeah, you can go next. So the first concept we will talk about is video length. People have reduced their time. There's a study that was published which said that people don't now want to watch videos above 15 seconds. People find it very hard to concentrate. You can see over here the average engagement versus the video length. As the video gets longer and longer, the engagement also reduces. So you need to find your perfect match where it's not too short, it's not too long, and you're telling your entire story. So these numbers are available to all of you all who have a channel. You can go on the YouTube studio and you can find all these numbers. So this is a very important concept of understanding how long you want to make your video and how much of time you want the viewer to be there. Yeah, next. Now, audience, this is a very important aspect, okay? Now, all of you all start a YouTube channel, but what if the person who's come over there doesn't stay over there? Now, the entire job of you as a content creator is to be able to keep that person over there. It's to be able to retain that person's attention. That is audience retention. How long can you capture and captivate an audience? Like if I do voice modulation, like how I'm doing right now, that will help to tell your story. But if I talk in a very monotonous way and say that this is what audience retention is, and it's really what we really know about audience retention is wrong, and it's about how people watch your video, that's going to be very boring. No, people will just click off you. So retain your audience through your voice modulation, through your expressions, through your, if your face is not seen, just through your voice itself. There are so many ways to retain your audience. Do amazing graphics. You can do, and this is a very competitive space. Mind you, you're getting, if anyone's getting into YouTube, competitive space, but a very fulfilling one also. So if you crack that retention, if you're able to retain those people, you've won it. You've won. Like, leave everything. Even if you have 5 subscribers, but all of them stay till the end of your video and watch it, you've won half the game, literally. Next. Click-through rate. Now, if you all, how many of you all know about thumbnails? Like thumbnails on the...
Me, I design thumbnails.
I also design thumbnails.
I'm planning to start a full-on business for it.
That's amazing. So y'all are aware of thumbnails, I suppose. So thumbnails are very, very important. Like, we take more time to design our thumbnails than even the video sometimes. Like, if you want the video to be... yes, I think Saria has a question.
Video to be watchable.
Huh. So that's what, right? It's like, it's very simple. It's as if you have a gift package in front of you and it has very nice packaging. Then,
judging a book by its cover.
Yeah, absolutely. You're judging the book by its cover, but there's this packaged, there's this nicely packaged box in front of you and there's one shabbily packaged box in front of you. You're obviously going to go for the nicely packaged box. And that is what the thumbnail does for a video. Whatever your content may be, if you don't package it well in the thumbnail, no one's going to watch it. So how many times a person opens that thumbnail, clicks through that thumbnail, is your click-through rate. Very simple. How many times you're attracting the person. Like, see, there are so many billboards outside, right? My election is going on. I must be seeing a lot of billboards of political parties outside. So which of these billboards is designed well to attract your attention is the one who's won the game. So that is what click-through rate is. Whoever can attract your attention, make you click. And that understanding that takes time, takes a lot of effort. But when you do understand it, it's amazing. Like, it's a beautiful skill to have. Like, what to put in the thumbnail, where to keep it, all those kind of things. So another concept, click-through rate. And then we'll talk about the favorite thing that people, you know, really ask us about. Like, if I tell someone I'm a YouTuber, they'd be like, "Are kitla paise karta re tu?" Like, खूब करता है तुम्हें छापता है पैसे दैट्स नॉट हाउ यूट्यूब वर्क्स वी तो मेक वेरी वेरी लेस मनी थ्रू यूट्यूब आई मेक मोर मनी थ्रू कमर्शियल प्रोजेक्ट्स दैट आई टेक अप बट यूट्यूब इफ यू वांट टू मेक अ लिविंग इट इज पॉसिबल एब्सोल्युटली एंड आई वांट टू टेल यू एनी वन ऑफ यू कैन डू इट आई नो अ गर्ल हु इज एज यंग एज लाइक शी इज इन फिफ्थ ग्रेड और समथिंग एंड शी इज लाइक पेइंग ऑल अ फीस डूइंग एवरी सिंगल थिंग literally through YouTube, just through YouTube money, right? And just see the numbers over here. Okay, this is not to intimidate you or anything. This is just to tell you, this is the amount of potential and money that is there on YouTube. See, y'all are young right now. The older y'all are getting, there's more money being put into content. There's more money being put into social media, right? See the amount of things. 24 million subscribers here. Here makes 22 million, 21 million. This is unthinkable amounts.
Tell him about Ryan's world. Who is Ryan's world? Tell them.
He's someone who is like a small kid and he unboxes toys and stuff.
He does just Lego toys unboxing.
Exactly. Yes, sir. He's like 6 years old.
Only Lego toys.
And so he's like 6 years old or something.
His target audience is children.
Yeah, he's 6 years old or something.
Exactly. Oh, if it's working.
She does all the time and she forces me to watch it.
That's what, right? How you all know about him? About it's like, it's crazy. That's the potential that it has. 22 million is unthinkable for an adult also. But YouTube has given this kid a chance to do this.
Obviously, their parents are also with him, but...
Absolutely, but just remember that this is the potential that it has. All these other people have big teams and stuff, and they're making there's a lot of money in this, remember. It's not like just like free stuff you're going to do. If you start a channel which actually works, you will make crazy amount of money, remember that. There's YouTube ads, which, you know, when you're the annoying ones that Zomato, Swiggy... This you eat, this you order, all those useless ads that come. They are very important for us. Maybe very useless for other people. But for us, that's how we generate our incomes. And that's why it's important. Is merchandise.
Sir?
Big space. Yes?
Sir, the top three most subscribed channels are from India. Two of them.
Yeah, absolutely. The only thing about India is that people make less money here because the YouTube algorithm pays you less, because the people in India are considered to spend less as compared to people outside. But obviously they make ton of money, a lot of money. So remember, money is never going to be a problem if you're doing this. Obviously you have to work very hard. It's not going to be just like you start a channel, you're going to make like 22 million. That's not how it's going to work. It's going to be a lot of work.
And it's also possible that all of you start and all of you do well. It's also possible that all of you start and none of you do well.
Absolutely.
But the whole thing is about giving it a try, right?
Absolutely.
I'm not saying everybody should also. You should feel it from within.
You should have that fire from within, I feel. Then so merchandise is also.
Let money not be a motivation, because I at this age, I'm pretty sure your parents are capable of taking care of you.
Absolutely.
Money will come later on, and you know, you can earn money as like Kabir is earning money already, right? Like, so he's just 16, 17.
I'm 18.
Hey, you can vote, huh?
Yeah, I can vote. So, yeah, so money should never be your motivation, but obviously, I'm just telling you that when there is money in any industry, that means there's a lot of scope in that industry. That means there are a lot of investors, there are a lot of people who want to put themselves out there and want to support you make the channel. That's why you have to understand that there is all this and there is crazy potential for you all to grow. Merchandise. I'm starting my own merchandise brand very soon. It's going to be called I Tell Stories. You all are one of the first people to know about this. We are working.
When is it coming?
We're not sure. Mostly in Jan, we are trying to release it, but we have already printed some t-shirts and got on-field testing done, and we're working with a lot of
I Tell Stories.
Yeah, so I Tell Stories is going to be launching really soon. Very, very excited for that.
Book one that's from what, already.
100%. I'll send you one hoodie and one t-shirt. So great. That's how we've metamorphed into a bigger chain of storytelling of a business now. And also sponsorships. I've got a sponsorship. You should check my channel out. We've made a video in Margaon. I've got a lot of sponsorship, but that one is the most prominent one. It was a e-bike company, and they were like, just travel in our bike and we'll pay you to do that. That's crazy. I just had to sit on the bike, take it around, and they paid me to do that. That's again YouTube. That too, I didn't have a huge channel. I had a very small channel. Like 3,000 is a very small number. But you can, because they knew that my work was good. People were following me at that time, and done. That's how you get it. And then memberships and all these kind of things. Never let money be your motivation, but also remember that there is, if you want to make this a career, it is possible. It is very, very possible to do it as a career. Yes, you have a question.
So did they contact you themselves?
Yep. Yeah. Like, I have a social media manager also, who mostly puts out these things but Bellingto had reached out upfront, because my channel also was associated with everything that they were doing. They were into electric bikes and saving nature and all that. My channel was also very on the same lines. Plus I was doing a video in Margaon. So it just collided, and we're like, let's do this collaboration and project together. It was a beautiful sponsorship. One of the best that I've worked on for. And also now I got a Belling e-bike. I have a e-bike now, the same company. So that's also really nice. So that was that. You could go next. If anyone has questions, you can ask me, okay? And yeah, most importantly, like, leaving everything aside, guys, just keep creating. Like, whatever you do, like any medium, I'm not saying only YouTube, just keep creating anything. If you're singing, keep singing. Have this creative bug in you all the time. Okay, all the time. If anyone wants to, I'll just tell you all this for your own references, but there's this thing called as ECA quota in Delhi University, which I also have got through for creative people. It's basically you get 15% extra for addition to your marks. So if you all work, see, now my 6th standard certificates and my 8th standard certificates, they are the ones that got me through this, because I had this proof that this is the work I've done. This is the prizes that I've got. So from now itself, do something creative, do something separate from your studies. You do your studies, absolutely. Do something separate. It may end up helping your career. It may end up helping you and live a more fulfilled life. So keep creating. Never, ever stop. If you ever need my help, need my guidance, you can take my number from Siddharth, sir. I will answer all your doubts, whatever you want to ask me. You can ask me. You can just mail me. I check my mail very often. Yes, you have a question?
What video editing tool do you use?
I use Adobe Premiere Pro. I use DaVinci. I use Adobe After Effects. These are industry level platforms. The ones that took me a lot of time to master. I'm not a master yet, but I know how to use it very proficiently. You can use things like Canva. You can use things like Filmora Go. You can use KineMaster. You can use all these apps.
Oh, Wondershare Filmora.
Yeah, Wondershare Filmora is also beautiful. There's so many free editing apps right out there. So do use them, whoever wants to create content on it. What do you guys use normally?
iMovie. Sir,
okay.
I use Wondershare Filmora.
Okay. That's really nice. So a lot of y'all can use whichever platform, whichever editing software you use. That's a simple thing to learn, just cutting and putting music, and it's a very basic thing to start, but as you also develop, you can learn a lot more also through it. So never let this technology thing like keep you behind. Keep experimenting with new kind of cameras, new kind of paints, new kind of whatever creative aspect you are into. So yeah, you could go next.
Kabir, I just wanted to bring a point here, since you mentioned like keep creating your work, whatever that you do. I just wanted to mention that when you will be out of your college, right, your CV will not be like the CV we used to have in college. It should turn into a portfolio, something that you start documenting right now. So Kabir, I've decided that each of these kids will have their own personal website by next year, where they will start posting whatever they have done, right?
That's amazing. Yeah.
Yeah. So I think what Kabir wants to say is also that your portfolio will become who you are.
Absolutely.
Right? If you meet someone tomorrow, you can just give them your email ID, this website, and they can check you out.
Absolutely.
Right? You need check not out to my,
yeah, you can right? check out my website. So kabirnaik.com. Yeah, it has all my work also. So yeah, that's also a very important thing. I feel it becomes your portfolio. And in this world today, like, no one cares about the degree that you have at this point, but the amount of work that you have, that is really way more important. Obviously degree is important. Obviously it has a lot of weightage in a professional setting, but the work that you have, it gives you an added advantage over someone who doesn't have that amount of work experience as you have, or the amount of things you've done and diverse kind of things that you've done. Yes, you have a question, right?
No.
I was asking, like, now in many apps, editing apps like Wondershare, Filmora, in that, like, they put watermarks. Now the problem is, like, they put less features and also spoil the video by that time, like with the watermarks and things. Now, like, I had downloaded Wondershare, Filmora, but they had put some watermarks and it was too big that the itself can't see what I've made in the video. Like, everything is hidden by the watermark. So, like, there are no free editing apps.
There are a lot of free editing windows, movie. You use a phone to edit or you use a PC to edit?
You have Canva, bro. I've given you Canva Pro.
Sir, Canva, yes. I'm asking for the account password.
Canva also you don't need to use. I think Movie Maker is there. There are so many free platforms. Then there is Vlogit, which is also a free platform. There are so many. There are a lot. You can just Google it out, right? There'll be like DaVinci is also a software which is free of cost for anyone to use without pro features. And see, you know what I've realized? The software that I've learned that time, it was way easier for me to learn softwares back then. Now it's way harder if I want to learn something new. If I want to learn a new software, right, it's way harder. But if you start learning in 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, it's way simpler for your mind to grasp it.
Yes, guys, that is true. That is very true. The amount of potential you have to learn right now, your mind can grasp. is way more than it will decrease from 18 onwards.
Absolutely.
Kabir is old now.
I'm very old now. So you should try learning all these softwares now only. So in the future, even if you're not doing filmmaking or if you're not doing video or if you're not doing anything else, you'll know that I have this extra software that I can flaunt or I can tell people about and just help with some video here and there. It's always nice to know software. And editing teaches you so much. You know, editing teaches you so much about so many different things. It's always nice to know. So yeah, try to learn at least one editing software, photo editing, video editing, whatever you like, and go continue doing it. Maintain the balance. It's also very important. See, you don't give 100%. I did that mistake. I used to just like do YouTube a lot. I didn't keep a proper balance. I didn't maintain a balance. I was like very into YouTube, but also obviously maintain a balance. And if you maintain a balance, that is possible. It's possible to have a channel and grow the channel and do your studies and excel in your studies as well. So keep this balance, keep doing what you love doing and continue this amazing journey of content creation. I think that's it. Keep telling stories, guys. I'm Kabir. It was really nice talking to you all. Super nice coming back to Vidyavriksh. Now, not as a student, but as someone who could literally guide you a little bit. And it was super nice. Thank you so much. So for having me. And thank you.
Someone to look up to, bro. Yes. Someone to look up to.
Thank you, guys. Thank you for being always. If you need anything from me, you can email me. My email address is thekabirnaik@gmail.com. And I'll help you out on anything. If you need my number, you can ask Sir for it also. So yeah, that's it. If anyone has any questions to end with, if you tell me how you like the session, if anyone wants to say something, you can say anything that you want to talk about.
Sir, what's the email?
thekabirnaik@gmail.com. Yes.
Okay.
No problem. So yeah, that is it, I guess. I don't
think anyone has any questions.
No, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, no, sir. Perfect. Hope I didn't bore you a lot.
Guys, I would like a few of you just switch on your cameras, no? Just share your experience with Kabir, like give him some sort of, you know,
feedback.
A thank you would also help, right? Like, who would want to go first? Or should I start taking?
Can I go?
Go ahead.
Yes, so today's session, Ruby's session was pretty interesting, and I like got the idea how to start a YouTube channel, how to post videos. And I think we should have such sessions at least once or twice in a month.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
As a trailer, I would just like bring in my students only, right? Like I think next in line I would have Rujula Manali come in and talk about studies a bit as well.
Yeah. Something I'm very far from, but yeah,
that's okay. Everybody has their own niche, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, anyone else would want to?
Can I say something?
Yeah, go ahead.
It's nice to have something different than just studying. It's a nice break.
Thank you so much. Thank you
this
so much.
This break can mean a lot, by the way. This break could be just a start of something new.
Absolutely. And keep doing your mass. That's amazing that you're doing this. And it sure will work out one day in a big way. For sure.
It is doing well. That's whatever
that's
I know.
Amazing.